Hey guys, it's Laurence. As always, I hope you're all doing good. Something that's really cool happened recently, which is my channel hit 3,000 subscribers and my Cliffs of Dover video is gradually approaching 1 million views. I think it's just around 900,000 now. So that's amazing, and I really want to thank you guys for all your support. So as a little thank you, I've prepared sort of segments of lessons teaching you guys how to play it. Now to go with this first lesson, which is the first half of the kind of solo intro bit, there is a PDF in the description box with the tablature, the notation, and it's got the picking patterns on it. So for anyone who doesn't know, the thing that looks like a paperclip or kind of like a, looks like this kind of thing, that's a down pick, and the V is an up pick. So even though the V points down, it's actually an up pick. It's slightly confusing, but once you get the hang of it, you'll be fine. The other thing on there is the brackets either mean a hammer-on or a pull-off. It's fairly self-explanatory as to what that is, because obviously you can't pull off to a higher fret and you can't hammer on to a lower fret, really. So if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notifications bell so you see when I upload more videos like this. And yeah, thanks so much for your support.
To start with,
so that's kind of like we call it moving in thirds. So we've got a little arpeggio there. So we've got an E minor kind of dyad there. Then we've got D there. So. And then we're gonna skip another note to go to the next note in the pattern. So this is where you get licks like. It's a really useful technique to have that kind of third skipping thing where you go, you miss a note in the scale and then come back to the note that you missed as like the starting point for the next one. So after that, we've got the first kind of flurry of notes. So the way we're going to play this is we're going to break it down into sections. So we're going to start with, so we start with an up, then we play a down, then we pull off, then we do an up and kind of bend this string, but don't think of it as like a, it doesn't have to be an insanely accurate bend because it's so fast. You just want it to sound like it moves from the original pitch. So I'm not really focusing on the pitch. I'm just bending that string a little bit. Obviously, you don't want to go. But you know what I mean. Is you haven't really got time to do like a really accurate bend. And now what comes next? So you want to pull off on that last note there. But other than that, it's all alternate picking, so. Cool, so we've got that first little section. So now we're gonna add on that next bit. So now what we're gonna do is play the 15th fret on the B string with an upstroke. And then we're gonna outline that D triad again, dyad again, sorry. Then we're gonna play a down on that and pull off. Then we're gonna play an up on the 15th fret on the B. So we've got. So far. And now this is the bit where it can get a bit tricky if you don't get the picking right. So we're gonna pick up, then down. And then an up again to finish that. Now we're gonna double back on that. Down, up, and then pull. This last bit, we're gonna do that same kind of not quite bent thing. So the next part of this intro, we are moving down to a different pentatonic box. It's still going to have loads of kind of bluesy inflections, so when we play... So we're starting down here. If you don't know your pentatonic here, it's... So I added on that extra little note. But yeah, it's really useful being able to connect all these positions. So if you don't know your pentatonics, I do have a video on connecting your pentatonics and making it kind of useful across the fretboard rather than just playing one lick in one part of the neck. Anyway, so back to this. We've got up, down, up. So we're just going up the scale, really. So all alternate picking as long as you start on an up. But that last note there is a pull off. So up, down, up, down, up, down, pull. And then we're going to do a kind of shifting kind of segments of the neck thing. So this borrows from my video, the concept of kind of sliding between pentatonics to make certain licks just flow better. So we've got that far, and then that's a pull off. So still an up, up, up. And then we're going to shift position. So that's up, down, hammer on. But you have to use your middle, your little finger for this. Because the next note you want to play, we do that little slide there. So that's up, down, hammer, up, middle finger now, and then slide. There we go, guys. That's the lesson one done for you. Hopefully that was really useful. Any questions, please just leave me a comment in the comment section below. Let me know how you get on. I'm always happy to help. I'll be posting more lessons soon. So as I said, hit the subscribe button, hit the notifications bell, and I'll see you guys soon.